everyone. This is book one, going over everything we learned this week in a video with skits and stuff. Really cool.
Kevin the bodybuilder was hard at work, pushing his muscles to the edge. Then along came his friends, Yasmin and Radhika, and asked him if he wanted to come along to a JY intensive course. Kevin respectfully denied it, as he needed to change his muscles. The friends were disappointed, but they understood and decided to leave him alone. As a JY group, they proceeded with the materials as Yasmin guided them with the Ruby process. Yasmin was a good animator, and all the junior youth very much enjoyed their class. The two who especially enjoyed the class were Jean-Paul and Claude. Suddenly, the JY felt a huge tremor, and it was an earthquake. Many suffered devastation. Yasmin assured her JY group it was just a truck and proceeded to finish the materials and go home. On her way home, Radhika came across an injured man. She and her friend Navid Patrice tried to assist the man, yet they weren't strong enough, so they called for help. Luckily, Claude was on hand to help, but they still weren't strong enough to lift it. So Claude called his best friend, Jean-Paul, to help. Jean-Paul appeared from behind a tree and ran over enthusiastically to help, but again, they still were not strong. Just as they appear to be lifting it clear of the man, they agonizingly drop it back onto his injured leg. Finally, it was time for their last resort. Jean-Paul called Yasmin. But even with her amazing muscles and ludicrous strength, they still couldn't lift it. Yasmin knew it would be time to call Kevin. She asked for his help because no man could match his power and explosive strength. Thankfully, Kevin agreed. With one fell swoop, he lifted the log and set his son Kevin Jr. free.
Thank you, Dad. My leg is free.
Kevin thought long and deeply to himself. I can finally use my talents to both serve the community and myself, while still looking good.
As youth from many different places and backgrounds, we all share our role, and that is to contribute to the better of society through spiritual and material progression. We partake in programs in which we learn about personal gain and gain for humanity through everyday tasks, but which we conduct with a spirit. However, since we categorize different tasks into the self-betterment and material gain, we sometimes get confused and can come across false choices where we may focus on one aspect too much and discard the other, and that's where we need to have a balance.
It might be a little while. A kindly tongue is the lodestone of the hearts of men. It is the bread of the spirit. It clotheth the words with meaning. It is the fountain of the light, of wisdom and understanding. Have you fallen? Fix the ratios.
I'm Yasmin Hussein and we're here to talk about the Death Cafe. For those of you who don't know, the Death Cafe is a place where people go to talk about their lost loved ones and their concepts and views about life after death. So let's go in. So hello there.
Hi.
I'm Yasmin. Who are you?
My name's Kevin.
So why are you here?
Yesterday, my cat died.
Oh, it's a very tragic loss, losing a loved one, isn't it? What's his name?
I'm drawing.
So, what do you think will happen to George once he's died?
Oh, because the cat happened to me.
Sorry, I lost the pet too. Okay, let's move on. Hello there.
Hi.
So, what's your name?
Clive.
Hello Clive, so why are you here at this lovely Death Cafe?
A close friend of mine died.
Oh, that's a tragic loss. What do you think happened to them after the event?
Well, he wasn't a very good person. So.
Do you believe in heaven or anything after death?
Well, I'm not really sure which one I came in.
Oh, okay. So you'd like to discuss with other people what they think happened?
Yeah.
Okay, lovely. I hope you have a nice time talking to people. So hello there.
Hello.
I'm Yasmin, who are you?
David Patrice.
Okay, so why are you here?
My brother died because he was hit by a car. A giant car.
So, do you believe in, what do you believe will happen to your brother? Do you believe if there's a heaven or any place after death, do you think he's going to be reincarnated?
I think there is life after death. I believe that the soul of my brother is in the good hands of God.
Also, you think there's a soul. Could you expand on what you think the soul is?
The soul is originated from the spiritual world. And it's related to the body during the mortal life, and after that, it goes in the God's kingdom.
Oh, so the soul's in the body?
I would say it reflects, the body is a physical form, and we and the soul is around us, and we reflect the qualities of God.
Hello there, I'm Yasmin. So who are you? And who is this Levi?
I'm Veronica. And this is my son. It's okay. My husband died yesterday. And it's very hard because my son, he just reminds me of him.
So, what are the reasons what happens to your husband after he died?
I think he's going to be reincarnated into a really good person.
So, all of you have pretty diverse opinions on life after death. Some of you thought there was an afterlife, some of you thought there wasn't an afterlife, some of you thought that you just got reincarnated as a better person. So, Radhika, how do people get reincarnated?
I believe that people get reincarnated because their energy is transferred from people to people after death, and depending on how good or bad they were in that lifetime, that's how good or bad of a family they will be born into.
Okay, that's pretty interesting. You don't believe that, do you? You believe there's a soul. So could you expand on how you believe, what do you believe about the soul?
From my point of view, I think God gives us a soul and a body, and there is a relationship between them. And we have this mortal life to progress our soul. And when we die, I think that the soul go to the kingdom of God.
Oh, so Kevin, what do you think about Navi's point of view about the soul?
Yeah, that was actually really interesting. I'm happy to hear that my cat will be able to go to heaven and have a good life in the next life.
Sorry, Kevin, but cats don't have souls.
Cats don't have souls.
Of course cats don't have souls. I'm so happy that my husband has a soul and that he's going to be happy forever.
So this is Yasmin from the Death Cafe. We've had some really, really diverse like views here and I think it's been really, really interesting. I really found it interesting about the soul and I learned a lot today. So I hope you guys have really enjoyed it and we'll be going.